Welcome back to the Underground. Today I'm going to walk you through circuit configuration menus on the Unison CMED and CMD control processor, in which this can be handy if you need to change your load type from incandescent to fluorescent or non-dim. So to begin, you're going to want to access the hidden menu located above the orange LED here. So press and hold for 3 seconds until you get menu stat on the screen. Now go ahead and press down until you get to an option that says circuit config. So you'll see that right here. Now you go ahead and press enter. That will give you your circuit option. So now this is the thing to note. This matches your lug positions on your breakers above. So we will arrow on down to get to 24 to work on our bottom one. You press enter. It will give you its module type. Since we're set to the 120 volt mode and this is an older processor, it's just going to give us this option here of L10, D20, and 15 and 20. Press check mark again. Here are your load types. This is where you'll change it. Now here you can navigate using the up or down button. Four wire fluorescent. If you select this, you need to make sure you have a Unison flow option card installed in the bottom of the rack to control the 0 to 10 volt sync state voltage. You have your two wire fluorescent. That's what we're going to set ours to today, but you also have neon cold cathode tubes, low voltage. If you're using an L10 module, you'd set it to that. And then non-dim, so that's if you want to keep it at a near constant 120 volts or whatever your max output is. But again, we're going to go back to 2-hour fluorescent. You're going to press check mark or enter, and then you keep your DMX address. You can change that if you need to here as well. We can keep it at 24, press enter, and then we're going to note our ballast type. So generally ballasts can be, they'll give you their ratings on there, 1%, 5%, 10, or 15 to 20. This one doesn't go up to 20, but sometimes up to 20. We will keep, there it is, 20. I just double hit. Go ahead and, well, I'll say 10, press enter, and then it'll ask you to save changes. You press yes, press enter. It configures that, and at that point, you're good to go. If you need to configure any other circuits, you'll just select the next number and go. Otherwise, press exit until you get to system OK, and then you're good to go. Thanks for watching.